Hey, Em. Welcome to the Pod Cafe. Just go ahead and take a seat, and I'll be right with you.
Oh, thanks, Nick. Good morning.
No, I walked away. I said, I'll be right with you.
Oh, so you're gone. Okay. Sorry. Well, you didn't even give me a chance to greet you back.
Yeah, sorry. We're a little busy today. What can I get for you?
Well, I already have something, so let me just tell you what I have.
Oh, well, this is really isn't like a BYOC, but that's fine, well, I guess.
Oh, thanks. So, that was like so Minnesotan of me. So.
So, okay, well, I have my own coffee.
I'm drinking a, you know, plain old-fashioned cup of coffee brewed from a coffee pot. And same. It's from a coffee shop in San Francisco called Sight Glass. I don't know.
Sight Glass.
Oh. Yeah. People really like it. I don't know. It's all right. The one I'm drinking is called Blue Boon, which is supposed
Blue
to be a mix.
Blue Boon.
Yep, exactly. It's supposed to be a mix of like milk chocolate, mandarin, and plum flavors.
That seems like a weird mix. I'm not really sure what a plum tastes like.
It's like chocolatey, but also like fruity.
Hmm.
It's pretty good. I would say it has most of those. I don't know if I would like pinpoint it on all of those items, but it's chocolatey and fruity.
Is it better than Phil's?
You know, I'm not sure. I feel like my first time at Phil's with you, it was like I didn't really know what I was doing. Now I've learned people do like half and halves, like they'll choose one and mix it with another. Yeah, there's like a whole thing that I just feel like I can't judge Phil's yet because I don't feel like I've done it right.
I just had a friend go to San Francisco and she posted a picture of Phil's on her Instagram.
Did she do a half and half? Did she
mix? I'm not really sure what she did.
I didn't
the
even know
The caption was,
a thing.
Did you even go to California if you didn't go to Phil's?
That's true. That's what I've heard. Hmm. That's why we went.
Yeah, I guess.
So, anyway, my Sight Glass coffee's good. I like it. I want to check out the actual coffee shop. People seem to love it there, but...
Oh, you just got, like, a bag of it?
Yeah, someone from work gave it to me, so I made it at home, but maybe I'll venture over there.
Did you get a coffee pot?
No, I have one at my apartment.
Oh, well, then why are you always making Keurigs?
Because I don't tend to buy coffee bags.
Oh.
I don't know why.
Okay. Well, I'm also doing that, too. But I'm drinking an Aztec blend, which I never had before. It's a medium roast. It's called Organics. I think it's Jewel's brand of coffee.
Oh. Doing some private label drinking over there. How is that?
Yeah. It's not bad. It's pretty good, actually. I don't know. The Rents here do that weird thing where they keep their coffee in the fridge.
Do you just call them the Rents?
Mm-hmm. Short for Pear Rents.
Mm-hmm.
It sounds better than pears.
Yeah, I thought you actually weren't supposed to do that.
Yeah, we looked that up one time, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. Yeah. I'm re-looking it up right now.
Okay, yeah, I'm pretty sure it said regular coffee drinkers shouldn't.
Yeah, they should keep it in the pantry, not the freezer or refrigerator.
Yeah.
It's creating too much moisture in the package. Mm. And moisture is one of coffee's biggest enemies.
Why is that, though?
I'll tell you. It allows for CO2 to escape.
Which is bad.
Yeah, because... coffee beans emit CO2 after they've been roasted. Interesting.
Oh, okay.
Like moisture. Oxygen is bad for coffee, so keep it sealed tight. Okay. You don't want oxygen in there. You don't want moisture in there. Okay. You don't want moisture in there because it can turn your beans bad quickly and dull the taste.
Technically, oxygen is bad for all of us. Because oxidization of our cells is ultimately what kills them, and our dying cells is what kills us. So really, from day one, we're just being poisoned by oxygen.
But don't we need oxygen to survive.
Yeah, isn't it ironic?
It is ironic.
Most of that's true, I think. I don't know the science behind it, but I'm pretty sure that's accurate.
Bad for you. I'm Googling it. Oxygen bad for you. We breathe air that is 21% oxygen.
That's it?
Oh, yeah. So breathing 100% oxygen would be harmful. Why? Pure oxygen is really bad and sometimes toxic. But our air is only 21% oxygen, so it's not horrible for us.
Only 21%? So we don't really breathe oxygen.
No, we don't. Pure oxygen is toxic because... that's a lot of science words. I don't like that. It's something with alveoli.
That's in your lungs. Yeah. Your lungs.
It's something about how the oxygen concentration gets into the alveoli and then... Yeah. Wow. Okay, I learned not much because there's a lot of big words, but...
Well, what is in the air we breathe, then, if it's not oxygen?
Let me tell you. It's 21% oxygen.
Yeah, that's... Might as well not be oxygen.
21% oxygen, 78% of the air you breathe is made up of nitrogen.
So we're nitrogen breathers.
Yeah. There's also tiny amounts of argon, carbon dioxide, and methane.
Methane is the farting gas.
Is it?
Yeah, when you fart, you release methane gas.
Oh.
So you're breathing that all the time.
That's gross.
Yeah, I wonder why they say nitrogen. We breathe oxygen then, if it's 70% nitrogen.
Yeah.
Maybe because... oxygen is the only one our body uses?
I'm trying to read about it, but it doesn't seem like... It's something with how we exhale carbon dioxide.
Well, we convert oxygen to CO2.
Oh, here we go. Guess what?
Huh?
I found this article, and it says, if air is 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, why do we say we breathe oxygen?
That's a good question.
Breathe 21% oxygen, 78% or 79% remaining. We don't care. Capture some O2. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, man. This is weird. I'm confused where this article is going. It says, nitrogen is the main component of noble invention dynamite. What?
Okay. Yeah, all right. Nitroglycerin?
Uh-huh. Oh. I think they say that because you can't use nitrogen the way it is. Like, it has to, like, even, it says, even plants can't use nitrogen from the air. The nitrogen they need so much has to come from a chemical form. I don't really understand this.
Where would they get that in chemical form?
Bacterias produce it.
Oh.
Yeah.
I didn't know plants needed nitrogen.
Apparently they do.
What do they need nitrogen for?
I have no idea.
I thought they just needed CO2.
Apparently they need some nitrogen too, but I really don't want to continue down this. It's too many science words that I don't want to keep reading.
Oh, okay. What else you got?
Well, I want to know how far you've made it in the Travelers show.
I don't know. Season 3, episode 2, maybe?
Well, I haven't finished it yet, but I'm pretty far. I'm almost done with season 3. But you know what I was thinking about when I was watching it yesterday? So I really like this show. I think it's good. And I was just reading an article
about... I think it's still going on.
Like, there's another season?
Yeah, I think there's one on TV, or is it a Netflix original? I'm not sure, but it says...
I'm pretty sure it's a Netflix original.
I was looking up some cast stuff, and it says present for the end date, so there's no end date on it.
Okay. Well, what I was thinking about was, like, so I really like the show. I think it's really good. I like all the characters. But at some scenes, I'm always thinking, like, how nerdy do these people feel when they're recording these scenes? Like, acting it. Like, some of the stuff they have to say.
Like, which ones?
Like, when they're talking about, like, different things from the future, and they're talking about, like, I don't know, whatever they're trying to, the chemicals and whatever's in that little machine thing that they were trying to get, and, like, I'm just like, I wonder if they laugh a lot while they're, like, talking about this, like, really futuristic world.
Probably. I bet you could YouTube a bunch of bloopers.
It just seems funny. But, in general, it's a good show.
It is a good show. I like it a lot. I'm interested to see what's going on with Philip and his, you know, his little visions he's having.
Yeah.
The last thing I saw was when Grant came home and Kat, his wife, got like nervous and then ran out of the room and hid. After she talked to her therapist, and then Grant was like, Philip, I think we're going to have to move forward with it. And then she heard him say that, and then the episode ended. So, do I know what that means?
No.
Okay. I didn't think so.
Well, I was reading about the show, and there are, like, distinct reasons why it's become so popular. I'm going to tell you them, and you can tell me if you agree with this list.
Okay.
One, it's addictive.
Sure. Yeah, they're great. They're very good at finishing every episode on a cliffhanger that makes you want to immediately start the next one.
Yep. The second thing is that the pacing is perfect.
Okay.
So every episode, like, holds your attention and then makes you want to go into the next one.
Yep.
The third point was that it keeps getting better and deeper, which is true.
Yeah.
The characters are all worth following.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. No one is two-dimensional.
Mm-hmm.
The rules are clear with fascinating complications.
Yes. Mm. Yeah.
Oh, I'm still not done. I thought I was done. The future is teased, but not shown.
Yeah, true. We've never seen it, not once.
Not once. It's heartbreaking.
Yes.
Yeah. The cliffhangers are insane.
Yep.
And then it's talking about season 3. But, yeah, I think those are all true.
Those are all correct. What are the protocols? Protocol 1, the mission comes first. Protocol 2. Mm-hmm. What's protocol 2?
I'll tell you.
Can't tell anyone? I think it's... Let me see if I can get them all.
Okay.
I think protocol 2 is you can't tell anyone about the mission. Protocol 3... I don't remember. Protocol 4 is you can't reproduce. Protocol 5...
Hold on. You're not right.
What do you mean? Protocol 1, the mission comes first.
Yeah.
Protocol 2... Is not, don't tell anyone? Is it maintain your cover?
It's, yeah. Never jeopardize your cover.
Yeah, okay. Protocol 3.
Is don't take a life, don't save a life unless otherwise directed. Mm. Do not interfere.
Yeah, do not interfere, okay. Protocol 4 is you can't reproduce.
Correct.
Protocol 5 is, they had like an episode on Protocol 5. Or no, it was Protocol 4. Protocol 5 is, I don't remember.
In the absence of direction, maintain your host life.
Maintain your host life. Okay. Is that it? Only 5?
There's a Protocol 6.
Oh. Have they ever talked about Protocol 6?
I don't think so.
What's Protocol 6?
No inter-team / deep web communication except in extreme emergencies or when sanctioned.
Oh.
So your team is the only group of travelers you should be interacting with.
Yeah, they've mentioned you're not allowed to do that. I don't think they've called it Protocol 6. Whenever he goes to that other medic, you know what I'm talking about? The cop lady?
Yeah.
But then, it gets deeper with the protocol H's, the historian protocols.
Yeah, protocol 2H. Updates are not to be discussed with anyone ever.
Yeah, it's the only one I know about.
Yeah. They also have two others listed. Protocol Alpha.
Oh. Which is what? They said Protocol Alpha a couple times.
It's top priority. Protocol Alpha requires all travelers to do whatever it takes to resolve the issue at hand. And then the other one they have is Protocol Omega.
They've never mentioned that.
And that is the director will no longer be intervening in this timeline.
Oh no, is that going to come up?
I don't know. I haven't gotten to that yet.
Interesting.
Did you watch the episode where they're at, like, I think they're in Canada or something, and they're at, like, that beach?
They're at the one where
and they keep restarting? Dying? Yeah.
Yeah, that was a good one.
That one was making me angry. I wanted to just yell at them and be like, can we not do this again?
I do think they restarted a few, like, couple too many times.
Yeah. Way too many times.
Yeah. There's been some really good ones. I really liked the one where they had to protect the future president little girl.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that one was fun. That one was cool. There was like a really, I don't know if it was the same one or the one like right after that, but there were some emotional ones where like, oh, the one where Marcy almost died when she was in the ice bath.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're doing a lot of spoilers here. Well, not really, but kind of.
Yeah, kind of. At least
sorry, guys.
Later. So if you watch it, you might forget about it.
What a cool thing, though. Wouldn't that be amazing if this was like a real life thing? Like people just out doing things to save this?
I had a story idea that's basically Travelers after watching it, and it's, what if, like, you know how people believe in miracles?
Mm-hmm.
What if miracles weren't random? They were supposed to happen, and it's because people from the future were doing them.
Oh.
Yeah.
Which is
basically, it's Travelers unless you make it for a different reason than saving the future.
Yeah.
Yeah,
well,
good,
I think
good show.
I was trying to think of which traveler I would want to be.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I like the Carly's role, the weapons girl.
Yeah.
Because I feel like Phillip's role as the historian is like the coolest, but sounds just really stressful.
It's pretty stressful.
And like sounds like you could really F up your mind.
Yeah.
And then the medic,
Marcy's
role.
Yeah.
Yeah. That just seems like everyone's always freaking dying.
It's also stressful.
Yeah. And I don't really know what Trevor's role is.
Trevor is isn't he like the machine guy? He knows how to build things.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
He knew everything about that in season one, that machine they had to like, when they were making the bomb thing.
Yeah,
he's like the engineer guy, I think.
Yeah, his role could be cool too, but like he doesn't do that much. I feel like the weapons chick is cooler.
Yeah,
and I wouldn't
want
to be the leader. Hell no.
Yeah, the team leader.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, most of Trevor's stuff is like related to his host. All the stuff he does, like in the president one, the little girl president one, they're like, we need you to run like a football player and throw the grenade at the car like a quarterback.
Yeah. he's just so funny because he's like he's just the oldest one, but it has like the youngest body. So I feel like he's always trying to like be really young and fun, but everyone's like, can you calm down? You're so old.
Yeah, he is the oldest of all of them, right?
Yeah.
They keep saying he's been alive for so long.
Yeah.
I love his interactions with, like, his host's girlfriend or yeah. or his dad. His interactions yeah. with his dad are hilarious.
What's his name? Gary or something?
Gary. You'll be all right, Gary.
Yeah. You're going to be fine. Yeah. It's so weird. I feel like you don't see the mom ever, but like you see Gary quite a bit. And it's just like, why is he not like, what's up with my son?
Yeah.
Like, it's so weird.
Yeah, it's so funny. And the girlfriend's funny. Or the interactions are when she was trying to break up with him.
Yeah. And he's like, yeah, it's okay.
You'll make the right decision.
Yeah. Well, it's a good show. I'm going to try and keep finishing it. I don't think I'll finish it today, though.
Yeah, it is a very good show. All the characters are very well thought out and different.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to see what else is going on in the world right now.
Yeah. Do you know what? Ugh. Haven't had enough coffee yet. Do you know what acro yoga is?
Yeah.
You do? Somebody asked me if I knew, and I said no. And they're a yoga teacher, so I assumed they were going to explain it to me. But I didn't get a text back. Yeah. So I don't know.
It's yoga, but like, you usually have, like, I think you have to have a partner. And you're, like, doing yoga poses with them. So it'll be, like, you know, like, when you're little and, like, we used to, like, fly on each other's feet, you know? Like, put your belly. Yeah, that's basically acro yoga.
Okay.
No, I'm serious. It'll be, like, someone's feet on someone's stomach and they'll be, like, doing a yoga pose or, yeah, it's basically, like, rhythmic gymnastics / yoga / being a child and just being held in weird positions.
Huh. Okay. Mm-hmm. Is it good for you, like regular yoga? Or is it like a sport?
I don't know. I've actually never done it. I think it kind of weirds me out because you see a lot of people doing it in parks and stuff, and I'm always like, those people are weird. No offense, but it just looks weird. Let's see. It's a physical practice that combines yoga, acrobatics, and Thai massage.
Ooh.
Yeah. It seems to be therapeutic, so I think it's good for you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Are you thinking of doing some?
Well, I just learned about it right now, so.
Hmm. Yeah, I've never done it. There is a place right by my apartment that does acro yoga.
Oh.
Maybe I should check it out. I don't want to. I don't understand the Thai massage piece, though.
Like, yeah, where do you get massage? Maybe like when your partner's feet are in your back or something?
Oh, yeah, maybe.
It's a little massage.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. It builds a practice of understanding and trust between the base. So there's a base, there's a partner on the floor, like, and then a flyer. Yeah, flyer. Partner in the air.
I imagine if I did it, I would be a base.
I think you'd be a base. For sure.
Probably.
It seems to be all the pictures, the man is the base.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Then the woman is the flyer.
Yeah.
Although, it seems like you can... Oh, in this picture, this woman... I'm just looking at Google Images right now. This woman is the base, and she has two male flyers above her.
Wow.
Wow,
she's holding them up
impressive.
At the same time?
Uh-huh. Like, one's on top of her, and then the other guy's on top of him.
Wow.
Oh, this one's a really tiny girl with a really big guy in the air. Interesting. Huh. Seems like you could do it either way, but the majority is male base.
Yeah.
Female flyer.
Hmm.
Interesting.
Very interesting.
Yeah. Hmm. Maybe it could be fun.
Yeah.
It also looks like you'd fall down a lot.
Probably. Well, not as a base.
Yeah, you're already down.
Yeah.
This woman is very pregnant and in the air. That's stressing me out.
Yeah, what if she fell?
Yeah, I don't like that.
Oh, how sad was it when Kat lost her baby?
Oh, that was so sad.
Yeah.
Oh, I found a picture of Barbies doing acro yoga. I think they're using Barbies to teach it.
Interesting.
It's freaking hilarious. Oh, man, that's really funny. All right, that's interesting. Yeah, I feel like that's, like, the stuff you see on, like, beaches or in parks on, like, a sunny day when people are doing, like, the... What's that rope that people tie between trees?
Oh, the slack line?
Yeah, the slack line. I feel like slack line and acro yoga are, like, one and the same crew.
Hmm. Okay. Well.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. I did a yoga class yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
How was it?
Pretty good. I'm good at what I thought I'd be good at. I'm good at the balance stuff and not so much the stretching part.
Hmm.
Yep. I got some pretty tight hamstrings and shoulders. Also, my secret head tilt was discovered.
Secret head tilt?
Yeah, my head. If I'm just like sitting or standing normally, my head tilts to the right naturally.
Oh, you're crooked, huh?
Yeah. So weird. It's like, for me to straighten it out, it feels like I'm tilting my head, even though I'm not.
Huh. What does that mean, then? Do you have some, like, spinal...
I don't know why. I remember in, like, sixth grade, someone told me about it, and they told me I just have to, like, stretch my neck.
Hmm.
But I just don't.
You want to hear something fascinating?
Sure.
People who tilt their head appear more approachable.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, because it's like, I'm just tilting my head. I'm easy going.
Yeah.
I'm just chilling all the time.
Yeah. So I think it's a benefit to you.
Good.
So it says... When a head is tilted by as little as 11 degrees off the center, giving you a left gaze.
Left gaze?
Yeah, they're saying, like, let me tell you more about this left gaze.
Does it matter which direction you tilt your head?
Scientists have known for a long time that we tend to focus on the left side of the face that we're viewing.
Mm.
Interesting. Okay. So if you tilt your head... This phenomenon is called the left gaze bias.
The left gaze. It's just like, always look at my good side.
Yeah. Well, it's connected to the fact that our brain's right hemisphere manages the task of facial recognition and processing.
Hmm.
Yeah, so if you tilt, it gives like...
It's if you tilt to the right, you're tilting... to that person's left side, so you're just like putting your whole face in their view instead of the left side.
You're like, yo,
hey, here's my whole face, not just my left side.
My whole face, but they're still gonna stare at just your left side.
Oh, so for any of you people worried about skincare and face care, you should really just focus on the left side. Focus all your attention on the left side. Who cares about the right side?
Yeah.
Now, is it my left or your left?
That's what I'm trying to wonder now.
I think probably their left.
I was going to say my left.
Huh.
So my right side. Maybe it's their left, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would make more sense. So when a head is tilted, we look at the upper eye more than either or both eyes from when the head is upright. So we stare at your upper eye. What does that do to me? Oh, this is interesting. The brain is a fascinating thing. Interesting. I'm going to try and stare at people's right sides of their faces now.
It's weird to think that my body has just adjusted so that with my head tilted, the whole world looks straight.
Yeah.
But really it's not. I'm looking at it tilted, but... My brain thinks it's straight. That's weird to me.
That's like when I used to go to the chiropractor and they to fix my scoliosis, and they would put me on a machine,
mm-hmm.
and like I would lay on this machine, and it the bottom of it, so they would move my bottom half, like so that I was kind of just laying in like a curve shape,
mm-hmm.
and then it would like go up and down, so like my feet would move up and down.
Yeah, yeah.
But
yeah.
I was just
the traction thing. I've been in that.
Yeah, yeah. But you're on an angle. But then eventually it feels like you're straight, and then it moves you back to being straight, and you're like, whoa, I'm really crooked. But that's not true.
Yeah. Yeah, it's crazy.
Well, I think your tilted head is an okay thing. It boosts social engagement, so that's
good. I do think it's why I pull my neck so much, because I haven't seen
a
lot.
Yeah, that could be possible.
I did it when I was in San Francisco.
Mm. Oh, yeah, I remember that. You know, if a horse has a head tilt, it could mean that they have an inner ear issue, because then the horse's like interior skull that then aligns to their ears doesn't line up with their muzzle.
Hmm.
Hmm. Interesting.
Huh.
So that's not as great in horses.
Who needs to go to vet school? You just learn it all online.
You really can. So, head tilts, good for people, not for horses.
Hmm. Well, I would tell you about the time I was behind a horse in a Starbucks drive-thru.
I remember that, and you sent me a picture.
Yeah. Yeah, I took a video of it.
What the heck?
That was pretty funny.
That is super weird. Was that just like a person's horse, or was that like a horse cop?
No, it was a person.
Where was that?
That was at the Starbucks in the same, like, strip mall place as Bartlett Gymnastics.
Yeah, I know. I understand.
Yeah. I do think there's a horse farm, like, across the street from there, or pretty close.
Yeah, there is. Right across the street.
Yeah. So they just got their coffee and then hung out in the parking lot for a little bit.
So, in Britain, you cannot go through a drive-thru on roller skates, a bicycle, or a horse. It has to be a car.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you cannot go through a drive-thru with a head tilt.
That, too.
So, you have to be in a car.
Mm-hmm.
Is that allowed here? Could I just walk through a drive-thru?
I'm looking at some articles here. In Texas, it seems to be okay.
Okay.
Sounds about right.
In the Wild West down there.
Yeah. It seems very by state.
Seems like a lot of things are.
Yeah. Oh, people have also successfully gone through drive-thrus on riding lawnmowers.
Interesting. Okay. Could you go through a drive-thru on Gus Gus?
Yeah. Yeah, you can do that.
I don't know why you would. Where would you put it?
Yeah, like hold it between my feet on the moped. Yeah. This place is telling me, Canada doesn't seem legal. Interesting. That seems odd. I feel like they would be chill with that.
Yeah. Weird.
Okay. Interesting. Wonder what else you can ride through a drive-thru on.
Probably,
like a bike?
Yeah, probably. Why not? How about like a camel or an elephant?
Oh, there's a child riding their like Power Wheels car.
Oh, that's funny.
That seems severely unsafe.
Aren't they tiny? How do you?
Yeah, they're really tiny.
How do you get the window?
That's really weird. One time I was in a Target in Iowa, and I saw a person just walking their miniature horse.
There was a horse in the store.
Walking with them.
That's bizarre. Is that allowed?
I mean, they weren't asked to leave, so that was
seems unsanitary.
Yep.
They want to bring a pony to on the hospital unit I work on for pet therapy.
A pony?
Yeah.
That seems
unsanitary for a hospital.
Yeah, because it's just going to, like, walk and poop.
Yeah. Can you imagine getting in the elevator and standing next to a pony?
No. I wouldn't even get in. It would just be like, excuse me, excuse me.
Yeah, and then it's got to, like, what, turn around in the elevator, or would it back out?
I don't know if they can walk backwards.
You don't think horses can walk backwards?
No, I think they can, but, like they're not sharks. Well. Like, I feel like they'd freak out and, like, I'm going to tell you.
All right.
Emus cannot walk backwards, in case you were wondering.
Emu? Isn't that like an ostrich?
Yeah, it is. But an ostrich can walk backwards. Do you want to know all the animals that can't walk backwards?
Yeah.
Kangaroos. Emus. Mm-hmm. Penguins. Alligators.
Penguins can't walk backwards?
Apparently not.
Huh.
I know. Okay, so when a horse is, like, trotting...
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's like a weird way that they trot differently when they canter backwards, if you will. They will touch ground one farther back than the other. Oh.
When they run, they do two and two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hooves do touch they? The ground in this. No, it's like a... They're saying that, like, when the horse is moving forwards, the hooves touch the ground in the same order. Whoa. Same order as a forward canter, you know, like one foot in front of the other.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yep. In the backward, they'll, like, do it differently, where it's, like, same side, kind of a shuffle.
Oh. Okay.
I'm watching a video about a horse walking backwards right now.
Oh.
Yep, there it goes. Forward, cantering normal. Yep. And then backwards, it's, like, weird. Yeah, there we go.
What do you mean it's weird?
It's awkward. It's like, it's just like shuffling. So, there's that.
Okay.
Let me tell you some other fun facts about animals walking.
We always end up on animals.
Animals are fascinating. Cows and horses cannot walk downstairs.
Okay. I think I knew that, actually, because everyone used to joke about the senior prank in high school being getting a cow, since we lived next to a farm, or we went to school next to a farm. Yeah, on the second floor, and then they wouldn't be able to get it down because it can't go downstairs.
Yeah, actually, they can't. You have to get it in the elevator, which seems like it might not fit.
Yeah.
I'm just reading weird stories about drive-thrus right now. This person is talking about how they worked at an ice cream place that had a drive-thru, and this woman comes and orders 5 ice cream cones, and when she pulled around, she had 4 dolls buckled in the back seat.
4 dolls?
Yeah.
That's a serial killer.
Yep, that's crazy. They should follow up with that woman.
Yeah.
Yep. It's just kind of funny. Do you remember back in high school when, like, coning was a thing?
Coning?
Yeah, do you remember what that was?
No.
I'd never done it, but it was like kids being assholes in high school.
No, so what is coning?
You order, go to McDonald's and you order a, like, vanilla cone. Mm. You pull around and then you grab the cone by the ice cream instead of the cone.
Why would you do that?
I don't know.
That seems like you're only hurting yourself. You don't get the ice cream, and your fingers get all gross and ice creamy.
It was like a viral video prank. You know how, like, there's always some sort of video that people are doing and then posting?
Yeah.
This was, like, one when we were in high school.
I don't remember that.
It's so weird. Yeah, it's, like, it's supposed to be, like, just a reaction for the McDonald's employees, or I don't know. Mm-hmm. You should watch some videos of it. It's pretty funny.
Yeah, I guess I will.
I mean, it seemed, I would never do that because I really like ice cream cones, and I wouldn't want to ruin that. No. But, and then, like, what do you do once you have a handful of ice cream?
Yeah.
Yeah.
People are always picking on drive-thru workers. There's always reaction videos where when it was big to, like, order a drink and then throw it back in at them.
Oh, yeah, that's so mean.
Yeah. And then the recent one is, like, people were dressing up as Shoot. What's the clown's name from It?
Oh.
I don't remember.
Isn't his name just, Pennywise?
Pennywise. They dress up as Pennywise. And then be creepy through the drive-thru. Or there was that one where that guy had that costume that looked like a car chair. Just like the seat in his car.
Oh, yeah.
And he would blend in.
That's funny. Yeah. And, like, that's so scary and unnecessary. There's a lot of weird animal ones, to go back to animals.
Animal
this,
what?
This person says, I work at an Arby's in Indiana. About a year ago, a woman came through with a pet monkey in a diaper on a leash.
What?
She handed me her money, acted like everything was normal, and then when I went to hand her the change, the monkey jumped in the window and took the change and then hopped back.
That's so cool, though.
Yeah.
I want that monkey.
Oh, wow. There's a lot of weird ones. This person's, like, avid drive-thru worker, so has a ton of, like, weird ones.
Oh.
Guy came through with a snake wrapped around him. Girl came through completely naked.
Oh.
Yeah. One had a car full of popcorn. Like, filled.
Yeah.
This person says, clearly got pranked earlier and no fucks were given. Wow, that's funny. Gosh, I bet you see a lot of weird shit in drive-thrus.
Apparently.
Yeah. A lot of weird things people are doing with kids. Like, full kids, full row of, like, six kids in the back seat. And, like, stuff that's probably just not okay now.
Yeah, stuff you would never be able to get away with.
No.
Do you remember when we used to just, like, sit in the trunk of the car?
Yeah.
When we didn't have room? You get pulled over for that now.
Yeah,
remember
that
seat in the station wagon that faced the other direction?
No.
What? We had a car, well, so long ago when we were kids, in the station wagon, and the seat in the very back faced backwards and looked out the back window.
Oh, I'm looking at pictures of it now. I do remember that. I mean, vaguely. Now that I've seen pictures of it, it's coming back to me, but
that's hilarious.
It says if you're over 30, you remember driving these wagons to Thanksgiving at grandma's. We're not over 30.
No, but we sat in it.
Yeah. Oh, there's this is a cool one. Some wagons featured a third row jump seats that faced each other and folded up from the floor. Kind of like a train.
Yeah.
That would have been fun.
Yeah, it's kind of interactive.
Yeah. Oh, you could never drive in these now.
Why? It's just not safe.
Yeah, people would just freak out about those. Yeah. Oh, I remember the backwards seat now. Vaguely, yeah. But I remember it. I wonder what they say about that. Like, is that a bad thing now?
Probably. Probably, yeah. Not safe to. I don't know. I feel like you'd be safer.
Why though? Then you could be like, yo,
get in a car accident. You fly forward. But if you're against a seat, your back's against a seat, it feels like it'd be safer.
Yeah, but there's, what if you're like rear-ended? There's no like airbag there to catch you, and you're just like destroyed by the back of the car.
True.
Although, it seems kind of fun now. Like, it's probably underappreciated when you're a kid, and you're like, wow, look at everything I could see. Now I would love to sit back there. You could, like, really crush some of those car games.
Yeah, different perspective.
Like, finding all the letters, yeah.
I feel like you'd be at a disadvantage, though, to the people facing forward, because they get to see everything first.
Yeah, that's true.
Unless if you're playing, like, I Spy, and you're sitting in the back, and you're the one who says, I spy, and you pick something behind you
win.
That everyone else can never see.
Yeah. Also, remember fun things about, like, car rides back in the day was, like, calling seats. Being like,
I call the chair.
I call the back.
I call the way back.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was debatable which was better, because the captain's chair, you don't have to sit next to anyone, you get your own little area, but the way back, you could lay down if it was a long drive.
Yeah. With three people, that's fine.
Yeah.
You know, as soon as there's a fourth, it just ruins everything.
Then you definitely need a captain's chair.
Then you gotta call a captain's chair.
Yeah.
Okay, I think there's still a car that has a third row that it faces backwards. I'm looking. Yeah, this thing. So the Mercedes-Benz E-Class wagon in 2011 was still being made with backwards facing seats.
A wagon? Yeah.
Yeah, backwards seats. Fascinating. Oh, yeah. Look at that. So they did keep this going for a while.
Hmm.
I wonder when we deemed that not okay.
Would they not be street legal anymore? Like, if I just had an old wagon, I'm not allowed to drive it?
I think you can. Oh, my gosh. When I was running yesterday, and this car... I was, like, waiting at a stoplight to cross, and this van, like, I don't even know what kind of van it was. Like, maybe a old VW van. Yeah, it kind of looked like a bus, you know, like a Volkswagen van bus, those old ones.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It had the driver was on the other side of the car, like the
right
steering
side.
Wheel. Yeah, it was on the right side. But then, so then when it turned, I was like, what the heck? And then the license plate was from Michigan. So I was like, what?
The only thing I've seen that on are like USPS trucks or UPS trucks or, you know, garbage trucks. Because they have a reason. They have to constantly be getting out of the car. So they put the driver's side on the right side, so they're not getting out
the
street.
Or like the mailman that has to get to the mailboxes.
Yeah, the USPS.
Yeah. But I don't know why this van thing had it on the right side of the car.
Yeah, that's weird.
I've never driven a car like that. I don't think I'd be good at it.
I mean, it's the same, right? Would it be that different?
I feel like I would hug the curb too much.
I would, yeah, probably. If you did it here, if you did it in a country where they drive on the other side of the road, I don't think it would be that different. It'd be weird if the middle, like the opposite traffic, was coming on the passenger side.
Yeah, see, that's what I was saying. Like, this car was right side driver, but still, like, normal, obviously having to follow normal California streets. That feels weird.
That is weird. How come the driver's seat isn't right in the middle of the car?
I don't know. There's got to be some studies on why that's not.
Is it to fit a passenger?
But then maybe you could fit two.
Yeah.
That sounds annoying, though. Let me tell you why it's not in the middle. Safety. Positioning the driver on the side near the middle of the road helps the driver to see further forwards around bends. Oh. For a bend that curves the same side that the car is driving on, the driver is away from the inside of the bend, so can see much further around it. For a bend with curves away from the side of the road that the car is on, the whole car is in the optimum side to see forwards around the bend, and the driver's position across the road is farther away from the inside of the bend than the previous case.
That seems... like, I don't know, does a foot really make a difference?
This article seems to say that if the driving seat was in the middle, the forward visibility in the first case would be severely reduced.
Severely?
Yeah, they're saying severely reduced. You won't be able to turn. Let's see what Reddit has to say about that. This person's like, it makes no sense. Why is it off to one side?
Why is it?
This person says, maybe it's an adaption from horse-drawn carriages. It's called. I feel like we're way beyond that now, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah, people are saying that you can judge the distance between cars going the other direction better, too. And it keeps you in the middle of the road. Oh, so then you're always in the middle. I understand that. Like on a two-lane street, you're always in the middle of the road.
I'm not following.
Like, there's a lane going straight on each side, and the driver's always, like, on the middle line, essentially, you know, for both cars.
Okay.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't you just stay in the middle of your lane?
I think you could. This person says, because cars with two seats in the front and four wheels and gear stick, etc., was successfully mass marketed and the trend caught on.
Oh, so it's a conspiracy.
Yeah, yeah. Hmm. Isn't there a car coming out where the driver's like in the middle? I thought it was like a Tesla thing coming.
Sounds like something Tesla would do.
This looks like a supercar thing. There's a picture that I'm looking at of like a futuristic looking car.
Hmm.
Oh, where they put the engine like right in the front center, and then the driver is the front and center. They put the driver in the fronter.
In the fronter.
Oh. Yeah, so in the fronter, they're saying they would give you more headroom, which I could understand that.
Yeah.
Got like weird curves to the side of the car.
Hmm.
This seems to be, maybe in the future, we'll move to the center. Who knows?
Yeah, maybe.
But we should bring those back seats back. Those were fun.
Yeah, those were great.
Maybe when we get the tunnels and...
The tunnels or the self-driving cars.
Yeah, then
anybody
we could
face
anywhere.
Any direction.
Yeah.
We you don't even like have to have seats. Cars.
No. You just need like a bench.
Yeah.
With maybe like a million seatbelts because, you know, they'll be like, safety first.
Maybe they could have like some sort of magnets that keep you strapped to the car.
That's gotta be bad for like just people's insides.
Well, you could like wear something. You strap
well,
in and then they can
we'll
move
all be
around.
Robots by then.
Yeah, maybe.
I'm looking at what the next 10 years in car tech will look like, and it's currently just a picture of a guy sitting in the driver's seat of his car, buckled in, right in front of the steering wheel, and reading a book.
Oh.
Self-driving.
Self-driving, yeah.
Yeah. So that seems to be the future. That's the near future. Let's see what else I got for you.
Okay.
Oh. Car connectivity should be sooner than it is. That's saying it's going to take a while. Like cars with Wi-Fi and stuff.
Don't they have those already?
Yeah, they do, but they're not that great, I guess. So I think it's going to take a few more years for it to be like fully functional. Or like having computers in cars where you could just like open your laptop. That's what this is saying. Like it's in the car. There's a computer.
Like built in?
Yeah.
I thought that was kind of what... Maybe Tesla
Isn't
just
that what,
looks
like
a computer.
Yeah. I also feel like all cars have computers in them essentially, right? Don't they?
Well, don't police officers?
Yeah, they do. Yeah, people are feeling really good about autonomous driving in like the next 5 years.
Yeah, I think we're pretty close.
Yeah. It's kind of scary to me.
It's kind of awesome. I mean... I think that Teslas are almost right there. I drove a Tacoma once that has like lane correction, so you can let go of the wheel, and if you start veering towards another lane or off the road, it auto corrects and puts you back to the middle.
Yeah. Yeah, it's those are cool. Crazy. When are cars going to fly? That's more what I want to
know. Never. According to Elon Musk, never.
Why? What does he say?
in order for it to happen, there would be way too much noise pollution. It would be super loud. It would be super hard to regulate. And, the energy it would take to do that is unrealistic.
So, yeah, that makes sense, actually. But for some reason, people still think flying cars are going to exist. I wish the travelers would tell us that.
Yeah.
Oh, Uber is working towards flying cars.
Okay, good luck.
Oh, listen to this. This is bold. Uber aims to have flying ride-sharing vehicles in the skies by 2020.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Okay, Uber. That's, yeah, calm down with that. All right. Well, that's interesting.
I don't know if I would like travelers to be real, only because I know that I'm from this century. That means I could be overwritten at any time.
Yeah, but don't you kind of think it's a good thing if you get overwritten? Because then...
No, then I'm gone.
Well, kind of, but you're born again as a new human. You're going to be gone either way. Like, if they don't overwrite you, it's because you died.
Well, what if I just don't die?
Yeah. Well, that too, but... I don't know.
I don't know.
That's all I got, really.
Well, we're past an hour, so...
Okay. Well... Whether you're from the future or not, if you're in the 21st, you can listen to our podcast. And you can find it on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, all the places you find your podcasts. You can tweet at us at @_podcafe, or you can email me at podcafe.contact@gmail.com. And yeah. What should we ask our listeners today? You know what I learned from our last couple episodes? For the most part, all of our listeners and Twitter followers are non-resolution makers.
Oh.
Yep.
Okay. I wonder which one's more popular. Making resolutions or not making resolutions?
Yeah. Well, according to our small sample set, they're non-resolution makers. But, yeah. That's what I learned from our last few.
I learned...
Which is good, because I don't want to hold anyone accountable and like, oh, God, that sounds annoying. Yeah.
I learned during the editing and posting process that we're doing something right, because every single month we go up in download numbers.
Woohoo!
We're just about at 200 last month.
Dang, what's our total?
Just under 1,000.
Let me know when we get to 1,000.
Okay.
I'm going to make it a big day on Twitter for all of our friends.
I don't know where the downloads are coming from, because they're not coming from Spotify. I think our most amount of downloads on Spotify is 5.
Oh. Yeah. You know what, though? I feel like that's, like... Because, like, we have Spotify Premium, so I don't download most things.
True. You know? Yeah.
So that's another confusing piece of data.
Yeah.
I only download things when I'm like, sometimes I download stuff before I walk to work because I get to this spot where Wi-Fi and service all cuts out and I hate when my podcast stops. But other than that, I really only download things when I'm getting on a plane.
Yeah. Yeah, me too. I wonder if it's iTunes. That a lot are coming from, or maybe just our website.
Yeah, that's true.
Have to look into it.
Okay. Should we ask our listeners to tweet us something like,
where are you downloading the Podcafe?
Could you let us know where you're listening to us? Or maybe tell us something you want to see in the future.
Or something, if you could travel back in time, you would change in the past.
Oh, yeah. Any of those three work.
Yeah.
Where you're listening to us, something in the future, something in the past. Right. We're pretty open this week.
Yeah.
I need more coffee, so I gotta go.